So you know when you're out traveling, you're on a vacation or road tripping or whatever it is, and there's all those like unplanned expenses and things that come up that can totally throw off your whole budget or make your trip going from like in budget to a little bit expensive? I've got 5 tips for you today on things that you can do before you leave on your trip that are gonna help you save a lot of money. Welcome back, I'm Brittany and this is Pennies into Pearls, where I am sharing tips, motivation, inspiration for you to help make small changes in your everyday life that are gonna help you in the long run actually start taking traction towards achieving these exciting goals you have for your family. Saving money is definitely one of those, and it is travel season, whether it's summer, holidays, anytime. These tips are gonna help you. Let's dive in. The first thing you need to do before you leave on vacation that's gonna help you save a lot of money is that you need to take a walk over to your fridge, take a look through your kitchen, your pantry, those areas, and see what you can maybe throw into the freezer so that way you're not rushing, trying to eat it before you go and wasting or letting it go bad. We're getting ready to go out of town for a little bit, and so there's some things in my fridge that I wanna show you guys to kind of spark some ideas onto to kind of spark some ideas for you as you're looking through yours. So meats definitely can go in the freezer and defrost for later. Even like these pre-cooked hamburgers and this pre-cooked bacon, I'm gonna throw in the freezer and then just pull them out once we get back when we're ready for like a quick lunch or some breakfast food. Breads definitely are great frozen and they defrost just as well. Did you even know that milks can freeze and defrost? So if the expiration date isn't gonna be good by the time you get back, throw it in the freezer. Tortillas, cheeses, now specifically like shredded cheeses work the best. Brick cheeses, cream cheese, sour cream, those things can be frozen. Just know that when you defrost them, they'll be better used in a recipe like casseroles versus just taking them straight out. But shredded cheese definitely defrosts perfectly. And don't forget those fruits and veggies. Those are great for freezing. These bell peppers, and I have some zucchini in here. What I'm gonna do is just slice them up, throw them in a Ziploc bag, freeze them. They'll be great for stir fries. Again, they're not gonna defrost perfectly, but if you're gonna like pan fry them, roast them, bake them, awesome. Same thing with your fruits. If we had some bananas or strawberries that are maybe gonna be going bad, what I would do is just chop them up, throw them in a Ziploc or airtight container for your freezer, and then those would be perfect for smoothies. So take a walk through your kitchen, anything that's gonna go bad, throw it in the freezer and you'll save yourself some money. Now this is kind of a little bit more of an obvious one, but you don't want to let your heating, your air conditioning blasting while you're not even here to enjoy that money just getting shot out through the vent. So you can set your thermostat for vacation mode or turn it down if you wanna make sure that your pipes aren't freezing and that kind of stuff, depending on where you live, what time of year it is. But just make sure that you're setting that thermostat. Kind of obvious, but we've forgotten it before and it's cost us around $100 that we just wasted when we weren't even here. And one of our pearls just suggested on Instagram that you can turn down your water heater also while you're gone, so you're not wasting energy and dollars to pay for it. This is a tip I've shared before on Instagram and you pearls love it every single time, so I'm definitely gonna share it again here. But before you leave, make sure that you pack up some of your medicine that you need for the adults, for the kids, maybe even for your pets if you're taking them. Because inevitably, at least for our family, it feels like somebody always gets sick or hurt while you're gone. So don't forget the Band-Aids too. I have those packed up in the kitchen right now. But that always happens when you're out on vacation. So stock up, use and bring what you already have. Maybe make that part of your Target or grocery shopping list to pick up while you're home. So that way you're not left in an unplanned situation and having to pick it up somewhere expensive like the gas station and paying double, maybe even triple the price that you would have already paid at home or that you've already have waiting for you at home. Now you know that I've got to include making sure that before you leave, setting up a vacation budget, a travel budget. And I'm gonna show you exactly what's in our budget for this trip that we have coming up. So you're gonna wanna make sure that you obviously include things like your flights, your gas, but make sure that you're including gas there and back. Also, your gas while you're traveling around. Do you need to rent a car? All of those. Lodging, of course. So make sure that when you're factoring that price, you're including the cost of parking, any fees, and all those fees included with lodging. Don't forget about including the cost of snacks. Now, snacks on the way there and snacks on the way home. Groceries for maybe while you're there, entertainment. I keep a separate budget for groceries while we're there and a separate budget for each of the meals that I know we're gonna be eating out. So we're not eating any breakfasts out this time because it's included in our hotel stay, but we're gonna eat about 4 lunches, which I'm estimating or budgeting $30 per meal, and about 3 dinners, which I'm budgeting about $50 per meal. So make sure to include that. Then of course, all of your planned activities. It's nice to leave a little spending for miscellaneous, souvenirs, and then maybe you wanna leave a little bit of a buffer for any unplanned expenses. Now, another expense that might seem small but adds up so quickly that people forget to include in their budget and plan ahead of time before they leave are the snacks. Let me show you how we do it and some tips to help you save money. Buying your snacks ahead of time before you leave at stores like Target and Walmart and the grocery store is gonna save you so much money compared to stopping and getting snacks at things like the gas station. And also, what you need to remember is to plan for snacks on your way to your destination, during your destination, and on your way home. So we buy all of our snacks for on the way there and on the way home. We buy those snacks ahead of time, but you saw in our budget that I do plan a grocery budget to buy snacks once we actually get there. So for the kids, what we do is we give them each a bag. So each kid gets a bag for on the way there and a bag for on the way home. And each bag has things like Goldfish, some cookies, pirate booty, pretzels, fruit snacks, just a few things. Trying to stay away from too much sugar like candy and that kind of stuff, so they don't go crazy. But we have one for on the way there and one for on the way home. I just keep them in this bag and it stays in the car. Now my last tip for you guys, and you guys know how much of a meal planning nerd I am, but do not forget to plan your meals for the day you're coming home and for the day after. You know why? Because a lot of times you're gonna be so exhausted that maybe you don't wanna cook, or maybe it would be better if you had something planned like a slow cooker. But even if you're still planning on like hitting up the drive-thru that night you get home and the day after, just make sure to include it in your budget so you can plan ahead, have all the cash ready to go before you leave for your vacation. Because think about it, if you get home and you still need to have dinner that night, and the next day is crazy with all the laundry everywhere and your house is a mess and your schedule is still crazy and you're trying to readjust to real life, if you go out and spend money on a couple meals that you didn't have already planned, that can really throw you over budget as well. So those are my tips to help you plan ahead of time. Do all of these things before you leave on vacation. It's not gonna only help you stay on budget, but it's gonna help you save a lot of money on your vacation. You can come home debt-free and stress-free. That's the best way to vacation, don't you think? Do you have any more tips that you wanna share with our Pearl community on how to save money, plan ahead of time, things to do before you leave on vacation? Let's chat all about it down in the comments. Thanks you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe, share it with your friends. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.